what's so special about chopstick? Ah, so many people talking about it. Did we get the right message from Boone or not? Hi, Abo and Aga. My name is Lee Lemoine. I will tell you what I saw from the date Boone selected to launch his book, okay? Everybody thinks 12-12 is a good day. But actually, 12-12 is a destruction day, you know. So let's see what the battle say about this day. So his speech starts about 1:30 p.m. So it's good hour. I think his intention is to bring value through information lah. But somehow his ego may have gone out of control and the cause he have in his mind blew up and covered up the value long. Then we see the rat and the ox combined. Supposed to be good one lah. Because people all come together, right? To see what we can get out. Then next we have the goat and horse also combined lah. And this combined give up passion. Very good for speaking and communication. So far so good, right? Okay, let's break this into half. Internal, external. So now we see the problem. See the horse and rat fighting over there? So they fighting for attention and limelight. Then next, we also see the goat and the rat, the hour and the month. Aiyo, these two form a harm. So things become provocative and people start to be emotional. Then all facts that were shared flash with the toilet bowl already. Then we also see the goat and ox, they clash ma. Wow, this one's stubborn. So this stubborn clash caused him to make reckless mistake. And this speech maybe was done during lunch hour lah. Maybe Toon also must be feeling hungry and thinking about eating noodle. So that's why he thought of chopstick. So I don't think chopstick is a big deal. Then next we see, actually this day is a month-breaker day. Because not only the horse is clashing with the rat, the gung is also chopping the jia wood. So it's like, aiya, month-breaker day. It's good for breakthrough and change, but not good for launch. Then we see the gung chop jia. Maybe his analogy not that practical for today's world. But most of his time spent is with the cabinet. So maybe it's applicable there. Well, when we argue, all emotions come up. Like people happy, people sad, people angry, everything. But do you know what? There are some people out there that are happy to see us Malaysian argue and fight one more, because the conflict we have inside will actually help them get what they want. So think about it. Then this good hour is also a hook hour, you know, that hook everything also get hooked out, all the parts get hooked out. So you throw rubbish into the sea, you hook out rubbish law. So if you throw fish into the sea, you get fish law. So at the end of the day, actually, every one of us thinking about same thing. We are all concerned about our Malaysian system. We are arguing from different perspectives, but all also concerned about the same thing. So think about it, okay? Actually, during this, I listened to this interview many, many times. I got hooked some valuable thing from his speech. I recommend you listen to his speech. Listen to his speech on Astro Armani and do your own filtering. See what you hook. Okay? So you see, he say every year now 2 billion ringgit we are paying interest. Okay? And it's a burden to Malaysian, which is very true. So imagine what we can do with this money. Where does the money get the money from? Or where does the country get the money from? It's true. So listen to this. Listen to the fact, okay? Listen to the fact, the value that he wants to share. So it's like our future generation will need to bear this burden. And this is just interest, y'all. The next thing, he also mentioned about Malaysia politics is all about race. It's also true about that. So, which part of our politics doesn't talk about race one? Very little, very few politicians, okay, which is really, really have the heart for Malaysia. So, with a multiracial party, it's very hard to get majority support. This one, you can go check the facts and numbers of our race distribution in Malaysia, okay? Then you will understand what he's trying to tell you, okay? Because some things I think he also cannot say so open. So we all on the ground live happily and peacefully. But we cannot stop what those people up there have to say. We can only do our part. So how have you contributed to this racial thing? I think it's time also we need to think. Okay, how have we been reacting to all these things? Okay. Oh, next are not only facts, I also hope some important message that I got. So you see, he said the next election is gonna happen like 6 months. We got 6 months or 6 months time to prepare. So it's like a fight or flight election, you know. So you want to vote for corruption or vote against corruption? Now it's time, you think. If we don't vote, if we don't come out to vote, we say, aiya, never mind lah, give it lah, whatever, so we won't win one lah. If we don't come out to vote, forever we rest our peace, okay? Don't talk about fighting corruption anymore, okay? Because if the corrupt party win, they will get stronger. So you think, you think what you need to do, okay? So what I feel, what I think, Tun is actually urging us to come out to vote against corruption. I know there are many people tired of this politics, okay? I'm also tired of politics. Every day, every year. Same thing or same story over and over again, just like a broken recorder. But if we don't come out to work for our future, then we are giving up on the future. So what you think? Well, the wise people say, the art of knowing is knowing what to ignore. But I say, the art of knowing is knowing what to put. What is beneficial to you? What is the value of the info that you can use? So share your thoughts on this video, like, share and comment, okay? And also subscribe to my channel, so when I upload the next video, you'll be the first one to know. Okay, see you next time.